The World Report on Vision is really important for a number of reasons. Firstly, it's the first ever World Report on Vision that the World Health Organization have published. And I think that recognizes, firstly, how serious the WHO is now taking vision and the significance of the issue. But it's also important because of what it says. So it's the first time that we've got together the full scope and magnitude of the issue. And it draws out very clearly that vision is a universal issue. Everybody at some time in their life will experience an eye condition or a vision issue. And that comes through very clearly in the report, and the scale and magnitude comes through. And from that, the urgency of tackling the issue. But the World Report on Vision also sets out the strategic framework for tackling the problem. And it sets out the framework for action at country, at global, and at regional level. And what it shows is that the scale and magnitude of the issue is enormous. It sets out that at least 2.2 billion people worldwide have a vision impairment. And of those 2.2 billion, for 1 billion of those 2.2 billion people, that vision impairment could have been prevented or is yet to be addressed. That's an enormous scale that it shows. But within that, of course, it shows that the burden of vision impairment isn't shared equally. That people in rural areas, people on lower income, women, people from ethnic minorities and from indigenous populations, older people, people with disabilities are all much more likely to have a vision impairment. And the World Report on Vision sets out that the burden of vision impairment is at least four times higher in lower and middle income countries than in higher income countries. And it's not just a healthcare issue. It cuts across many of the sustainable development goals. It cuts across improved productivity and the economy, improved education, gender equality, and the ability to participate in daily life. We haven't got enough research that underpins that, but the research we have shows that, that, for example, a study that was published last year showed that productivity in tea workers in India increased by between 20 and 30% when they had access to proper eye care services and access to glasses. In children, it's thought that eye care is probably the single most cost-effective healthcare intervention for education, and that giving children, again, access to proper eye care and access to properly prescribed glasses can have the equivalent of the impact of an extra half year's education for them. In road traffic accidents, it's estimated that people with a vision impairment are 30% more likely to be involved in road traffic accidents. So what that shows is that eye care really cuts across many of the sustainable development goals. Having access to proper eye care can reduce poverty, can give access to good quality work, good quality education, can improve gender equality. In many respects, it's a kind of golden thread that runs through all the sustainable development goals. So the problem isn't simply that isn't that we don't know what to do. The problem is that we haven't yet got the will, and we haven't yet managed to integrate eye care into mainstream services. So the World Report on Vision sets out five high-level recommendations for how to do this. Firstly, eye care needs to be integrated and be a core part of universal health coverage. Secondly, it recommends that it needs to be implemented as integrated people-centered eye care as part of health systems. Thirdly, they recommend promoting high-quality research into eye care. Fourthly, obviously, this needs to be monitored and evaluated. And finally, communities need to be empowered so that they are actually involved in the delivery of eye care services. Of course, critically, universal health coverage is not universal if it does not include eye care. And we will only get lasting and sustainable change when eye care is properly integrated as part of universal health coverage. And that needs to start at a national level with the plans and strategies. At the UN launch of the World Report on Vision, the World Health Organization representative told us that of the 194 national health plans and strategies that are lodged with the World Health Organization, precisely three mention eye health and eye care. So that means that there are 191 countries who do not mention eye care or eye health as part of their national health plan or national health strategy. and at the core of what the World Report on Vision is saying about how eye care can be implemented as part of a country's health system is integrated people-centered eye care. And that means that eye care needs to be part of the full continuum of health services at promotion, prevention, treatment, and rehabilitation level. And so that means that eye care needs to be integrated as part of primary care services, at secondary care, and at specialist level, and that there need to be referral pathways between those all those levels, and that eye care needs to be implemented in people's homes and in communities as well. So I think this is a critical moment for eye health. On its own, the World Report on Vision won't be enough. We need to use it to persuade governments of the critical importance of eye care and of the scale and the magnitude of the problem. It obviously marks the end of Vision 2020, and it's important that we recognise the successes and achievements that we've had. But it's also an opportunity to really set a new agenda for the new decade. And the World Report on Vision really gives us that opportunity. And the World Health Organization has already identified two eye care indicators as part of its package of 30 indicators for universal health coverage. Those two indicators are effective coverage of cataracts surgery and effective coverage of uncorrected refractive error services. So what it's proposing is that those are two of the 30 core indicators that the World Health Organization has to measure the implementation of universal health coverage across the board.